wyrabiać w sobie silną wolę, odwagę i prawdomówność. Ślubujemy.
Als geboren en getogen Nederlander te vertellen wat mijn bijzondere band is.
Jestem dumny z tego ojca i cieszę się bardzo, że mogę tutaj być dzisiaj przy otwarciu szkoły, która nosi jego honorowe nazwisko. Dziękuję bardzo.
Cześć, here I am again. We are at the Maricanal, where on the 3rd of November, the Polish 1st Armored Division built two bridges and finally crossed it after 2 days of hard fighting. And here we will pick up on the story of Marian Plichta, a lieutenant with the 1st Polish Armored Division in the 10th Mounted Rifles Regiment. And today I will accompany his daughter, Joanna Wilgat, in the traces of her father, find out where he was finally wounded. And here, as you can see, this monument, the 3rd of November 1944, marks the start of our trip with his daughter to find finally the place where her father was wounded on the 4th of November 1944. Nobody has been able to tell her, and today we are going to find out together.
Mój tata, porucznik Marian Plichta, oficer 10. Pułku Strzelców Konnych 1. Dywizji Pancernej generała Maczka, walczył pod dowództwem generała między innymi o wyzwolenie Bredy i w pobliżu Bredy był ranny 4 listopada 1944 roku.
And this is the place, Munnikenhof it was called at that time, but it was a big farmhouse, klein en groot, Munnikenhof. Marian Plichta and other soldiers and officers stayed for the night, and when Marian was wounded, his other colleagues were put back here to be in a safe place before attacking again on the 5th of November. So we now continue the road as he followed the day that he got wounded.
The history of the 1st Armored Division can be found in books, but also like in Holland, in a chapel like this, are memories of Polish soldiers who once stayed here. As you can imagine, it was a hard time driving for a commander of a Cromwell tank in 1944. If you look at the curves and the small roads, they had to drive to town, people perhaps cheering them when they saw the liberators. It really was a hard task. Definitely sure your father passed here. If you want some evidence, then you will see that his Cromwells passed this windmill.
Oh my God!
We are standing at the crossroads just outside Ter Heiden, as you can see on the map near my thumb. This is the crossroads where they divided the troops towards Moerdijk. One behind me in the direction of Blauwesluis. In front of me, Lieutenant Marian Plichta and his tanks were ordered from this point towards the Drie Hoefijzers and Zevenbergse Hoek. This place is called the Drie Hoefijzers. And I know from the description of Joanna's father that it was one of the places he was ordered to go to. And it also is mentioned in a part of the diary of his unit. That's why it was important for me to find this place. The problem you're confronted with when you're doing historical research is to know what are you looking for. And I knew from the diary I had to look for a bridge. But as it was a very small road in 1944, I was looking for a place where it crossed a waterway. And here we have it. This is the waterway, the old so-called bridge, and towards the other end with the water. And when they stopped here and found out that there were mines led by the Germans, the moment they saw it and got out of their vehicles, the Germans started shelling them with mortars. So they had to have to get the hell out of here with our tanks. And then we will find a place where Joanna's father was wounded. The next information I had is the fact that they drove back because the Germans were shelling them with the tanks backwards towards the corner, about 200 meters away of it, with a few farmhouses and a cafe called the Toll. And then it happened, there was a Jagdpanzer, German tank, disabled by fire a few days earlier, and the tank of Marian Plichta, by driving back in a very difficult maneuver, he hit a German Jagdpanzer, disabled tank standing on this corner, and by hitting it, it made a move with his tank and he slid down into this deep ditch. And that was the way he got wounded in 1944, the 4th of November. This is the exact spot I can tell now to Joanna, where her father was wounded.
You're welcome.